Okay. Welcome back to Cheche, live on Citizen TV with our guest today, the governor of Embu. He could be the former governor of Embu, but he's appealing the Senate's decision to uphold the second impeachment on him by the County Assembly of Embu. And sir, there's a text message here which will form the basis of my question to you. All Embu MCAs should be charged for court contempt, and the Chief Justice must wake up. They should be jailed because there's no democracy in violating court orders. Wambora is the governor. And that came from Ngetich in Eldoret. Do you agree that any sort of action should be taken against your MCAs in Embu?
Let the Ethics and Corruption Commission investigate them, because they have irregularities, employment and financial irregularities.
Is the matter with them?
The matter is already with them.
Okay.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of evidence.
You're not seeking their hand, are you? Even in these troubled times, you are setting the police on them.
No. We must work. There's no compromise over irregularities.
All right.
Absolutely.
Let's do some confession here. How do governors work with MCS? What is your experience? Are you at war all the time?
No, the war only came again, as I said, at the end of December. If we can sort out those issues, they stop those payments, we shall begin reconciling.
Mm-hmm.
I
suppose the wider question David is asking is in general, because you've talked about turf wars, supremacy battles, and so in general, how do your colleague governors work with their county assemblies? Is there a harmonious working relationship, or are we seeing the sort of acrimony that we've begun to see between governors and their senators?
It would have been easier for me if there was no interference from outside the county. We can sort our own problems with the
MCAs. What do you mean by interference from outside the county?
Because now if MCAs are being funded to go to Mombasa by air, and being paid for allowances per DMs to discuss impeachment of a governor, if they are being funded, as they claim.
By who?
I would leave that to the MCAs.
You're making an allegation.
It's an allegation, and I'll put this to you, because the Council of Governors Chair, Isaac Ruto, has accused the Jubilee administration of funding MCAs to rein in governors who don't seem to be towing the Jubilee line. Are you echoing that allegation? Is that what you're saying here?
No.
What are you saying?
I'm not echoing that position, because I don't have hard facts. But I know some MCAs have admitted, like the first time in January, when they broke away from Mombasa and came back to Nairobi to meet me, they told me they had been offered money and all that. So,
but
we shall be raising these issues. I'm going to organize
who offered them
to
money?
Appear before the big
Mr.
question
Wambora,
with MCAs.
Who offered these MCAs money?
May I not mention names? Yeah.
Okay, wait. Let's get to the bottom of this, because during the Senate vote yesterday, we had about 35 people voting to impeach you. We had a dissenting voice from Senator Gideon Moi of Baringo, and your own Senator Lenny Kivuitu from Kivuitu. Sorry,
Kivuti.
Kivuitu.
Kivuti.
Kivuti.
Lenny.
Sorry,
Lenny.
Thank you. Abstained from the vote. Do you see any sort of dynamic there?
Yeah, there are dynamics, because the same my senator, they approached me with his lead of the party, and they said they are going to team up with me to now create peace in Embu. But when the bishops called the meeting, they were not able to deliver their MCAs who were under them. So that was very sad.
So what is the dynamic? That they're working against you, or that they can't support you?
No, I mean, they promised to work with me, but when they came to the problem, they did not follow their words.
What mean work with you? Work with you means what in this context?
They were
close their eyes to
wrongdoing? I'm having 11 MCAs who are loyal to me, and they have 7 APK. That would cause more than enough majority.
Right.
That was their promise.
So the idea was to create a majority, a tyranny of numbers that would make you immune from any action.
at least be
or what is working
to be effective mean? To be effective, that's what it means.
In
to be able to deliver, to be able to deliver, because even development has now suffered as a result of this stalemate, and the 190 of Embu County are fed up. That's why they have to correct signatures for the county government to be wired up, so that we can have fresh elections, so that they can give them governor, MCAs who can work with him.
So you want fresh elections?
I am for it. If it was to be, we have already submitted those signatures to the president.
But if the president. Impeachment is upheld by the Supreme Court, you wouldn't be able to contest in fresh elections, because you'd be barred from public service.
I will not contest.
Yes. Wait, you are saying you have submitted signatures to the president for what?
To dissolve the county government. Not me, the Wajikos. They have submitted.
Yes.
And I could understand their anger.
Yes.
Because we're able to correct so many signatures, Bwanajao, Mutegi, in 2 days only.
100,000 signatures.
26th and 27th. Mm-hmm. 8 to 6, 10 hours, 20 hours, yes. So many signatures, shows how frustrated they are.
But the president, under the constitution, has the option of suspending a government, county government.
And
is
that's
that
exactly
what you're asking for?
That's what the
suspending the government.
That's what the Wajikos have asked.
Is not equivalent to elections.
No, no, you paid it for 90 days.
Yes.
Then the Senate would now give authority for fresh elections.
That's what you are going for.
That's
what you would support.
That's what the Wanaindi are going for.
And you?
I would support it to break the stalemate.
What about you? You are going to the Court
Supreme
of Appeal?
Court.
Or Supreme Court?
Court of Appeal first, and then, of course, if.
Have you already gone to the Court of Appeal?
We have already filed.
You have filed?
Yes.
So you don't think you're arguing your case here instead of the court?
Because the court will be next week or so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, it hasn't come before
the proceedings
court
have
yet.
Not started yet.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's why I'm having this break. That's why I accepted the offer of citizen to come and present my case.
Let's examine the validity or the uprightness of your action in refusing to appear before the Senate this time round.
Mm.
What were your solid arguments? You say you had given them documents. They did not look at those. You did not think it worthwhile to go back with the same document to submit before the Senate?
No, because we had already, they had the documents already. Number two, it was an issue before the court. It would have committed what they call sub judice.
Mm.
Number three, there was the issue of the period before another impeachment takes place. We believe it was 3 months. And we shall continue with this argument, even in the Court of Appeal. It should be 3 months.
Yes, before the same motion comes before the
but
House.
But then the court, when you appealed the second time, the court found that the charges were not the same and felt that the 3 month period did not apply, because the first appeal found that the charges against you were null and void.
Of course, we don't agree with the court.
You don't agree with
we don't agree with the High Court decision. That's why we are going to the Court of Appeal. Number four, there's something called dual jeopardy.
Yeah, double jeopardy.
Yeah, double jeopardy.
That you're being prosecuted on the same facts
exactly.
And the same matter twice.
They are the same.
But let me go back.
That's
on
why the documents are the same, which are the same.
But Ms. Wambora, let me go back on the effect of your first application, which nullified the impeachment process, was to render it non-existent, in fact. Wasn't that the case? When the court ruled that the whole process was null and void.
But now,
meaning, in fact, on the ground, there was no impeachment that happened.
Yeah,
so then you cannot say it takes 3 months to bring back the same motion, which didn't exist in the first place.
You know what happened? Again, the president in other countries, there's a case which went all the way to the Supreme Court. And the day of, you began counting the end of impeachment, not at the date of the Senate, but at the date of the court proceedings, because we are appearing. Your impeachment proceedings, which have been conducted by the Senate. So for us, we have a different understanding, which we shall still carry through all the way to the
Supreme. So you say you're still a governor. Are you going to the office? Are you working? You're driving a car, yes, but are you working?
Yes, of course, I'm going to.
Are you able to perform your duties? That's what Mateng is asking.
Yes,
how?
Yes.
When you don't have the cooperation of the county assembly, your office is in disarray because you cannot perform anything.
No, things are still moving on. Things are moving on, but not in a fast scale. We passed the financial bill, we passed the supplementary budget. It was passed, even when I was out. Now, what is really paining me most is I was in this program, I think, in the morning breakfast show, and you interviewed me, the two of you, about the investors conference of October last year.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now that cannot move, cannot be implemented without stopping these sideshows.
Okay.
And good publicity.
But just
so
to
are you telling me
go back
the question
to the question
is
of whether you're working.
Are you working? Are you going to the office?
Yeah. Of course I'm working.
But how can you work with no authority? Because, hang on.
Yeah.
The Senate has upheld the decision to impeach you.
Yeah.
Your county assembly does not want to work with you. They have impeached you. So what are you doing, even if you're showing up at the office every day?
May I tell you one thing, Amima? The Senate and the county assembly did not elect me. I'm responsible to the
You're not
the
answering
of Embu.
My question.
No, I'm telling you.
What happens when you go to the office?
I was launching 40 million of bursary with MCS last week.
Right.
They were there.
Okay.
Calling me, Your Excellency.
Yes, but that was last
calling
week.
Calling me, Your Excellency.
That was last week.
Yes.
So what will happen today after this show?
Huh?
You will go and launch something else with the same MCAs?
Yes. Yes.
It's a very bizarre relationship
because,
you have.
Yes, because, we are doing it.
Let's say
what must be done.
Are you not concerned, Ms. Omora, from a moralistic point of view and in the public interest that the government of Embu County is unable to perform and you are at the core of that failure to perform? I mean, now matters revolve around you and you have held the whole county at ransom.
It's not me.
Because of your attempts to stick,
it's
to cling
me.
On to the governorship.
It's not me.
But think about when
the
you...
The people are refusing to dialogue.
Where are the people?
You
can speak in the name of the people.
The MCs who are refusing to dialogue when they are called by the bishop are the ones holding the county at ransom, not me.
Okay.
Me, I'm ready to dialogue with them.
But
right,
if we follow...
I'm ready to dialogue with them. So
Mr.
the people
Wambora.
Are holding... This, and that's why the people are signing all these documents, petitions, so that governor can be given MCs who can work with him.
Okay.
But I'm still having support among quite a number of them.
Mr. Wambora, you sacked your county secretary because at some point you felt that public opinion... meant that she could not work.
He's under pressure.
You are under pressure. And
yeah.
at the moment you're under pressure.
My
why do you refuse to step
because
aside?
Because very simple. My county secretary is an employee.
He's an employee.
I'm an elected, popularly elected leader. We are not the same.
Yeah. Right.
I'm not even a soleil.
What would make
And
you
these issues were mentioned in the Korea court.
Right.
And it was ruled that an elected official
yes.
cannot just succumb to a few. It's not
okay,
possible.
The point is this.
I'm responsible to over 560 Embu people. Voters.
You also appreciate that the MCAs got elected similarly, and they are representing, if we follow the dictate of democracy, that they are also speaking in the name of their electorate.
Now, Jao, I mean, David.
Yes.
This afternoon,
yes.
the court is going to rule on whether they did, whether the MCAs can mobilize the impeachment of a governor. There's a citizen of Embu. The case is in before the same judge called
Mwongo. Yes.
This afternoon.
Yes.
Because they did not consult their ward people. They never consulted. They did not consult them, so there was no public participation.
Is there,
so
there's a requirement for public participation? And what format does it take? There is nowhere in written in the law.
No, but it's in the Constitution.
Public
we always work on public participation on issues of budget, on issues of policy, on issues of planning. We must also do it in terms of impeachment of a governor who has thousands and thousands of votes.
Okay.
So it is going to be determined this afternoon.
Our official time is up. Let me just go through some of what our viewers are saying.
And I hope
in typical Kenyan fashion, many of us are condemning Mr. Wambora without consideration to his side of the story. Surely the man is still not done. Please, fellow Kenyans, acquire the art of thinking for yourselves. Avoid the bandwagon. That came from Ismail in Mombasa. Stephen Meru, the governor may be speaking the truth, but the courts do not help him to govern. He should go home peacefully. How is a governor supposed to know that a variation was done? It is unfair some of the things we expect governors to do. But then, Cheche, ask Mahesh Miwa, since he took over, no bursary was awarded except for last week, but it was given to rich students. He should be impeached. And it is surprising that the governor does not see the difference between delegated authority and responsibility.
Yeah.
It's a pity. Earlier, I had given Governor Wambora the benefit of the doubt, but having listened to him on Cheche, there must be more mess than we have heard. Moses in Kitengela.
Now, the bursary was given to the poor people. The MCAs participated in supervising the bursaries. The MCAs, the 20 erected MCAs participated in the distribution of the bursary, and they were all very happy. Everybody is happy in Embu. If they are not up in Kitengera, pole sana. Now, can I make my closing remarks, please?
Just a minute before you give us your closing remarks, because you seem to be quite upset with us now.
No, 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 not with you.
No, what are you upset about?
Because some of those questions are being made by people who don't understand issues.
Who don't understand issues.
Absolutely.
Quite a few of them think you're being arrogant, and that would, you know, they would say that's a display of arrogance.
They don't matter.
They don't matter. Well, before we close, Mutegi, what do you think?
Just the same. I haven't changed my proposed opinion.
He's not been able to sway you.
His trouble is his politics. He seems to not know the politics. He went to court, and he needs to do politics, not court processes. He needs to do politics and understand politics. He has member of parliament, and I think when it comes to that local politics, yeah, he seems not to understand. Mm-hmm. And I think he needs to manage his relationship with the If he were to take them to the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission because they give themselves those allowances, and he thinks that they are going to work with him, it's not proper allowance, but he needs to sort it out at home,
okay.
Not in Nairobi.
Right. David?
Well, I seem to share the remark expressed in one of those SMSs.
Which
Somebody
one was that?
Said, Governor Ombora does not seem to differentiate between delegated authority and responsibility. Governors are responsible for their government, for their county. People have authority to perform certain tasks under you, but ultimately you must be concerned, not necessarily interfering. For example, procurement is being done under your supervision. You don't have to meddle, but you must know what's going on, and when they bring before you to approve, you must have questions to ask about them, because ultimately you are the supervising or overall authority. I think that he has, fought a good battle, and he's tenacious. But my question is, so what even if the court reinstated you, mm-hmm. and you don't have the political goodwill on the ground to govern? Mm-hmm. What is the ultimate end? And that is really the moral question that he needs to battle with.
So you're pretty much saying
you
the same thing. Even if you
say,
win,
okay, yeah. innocent,
you still have to work with the people who have fought you twice.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So you want to make your closing remarks?
Yes, yes. I'm very grateful you gave me this chance. And I want to start by appreciating my Embu voters who have been paid for not getting a chance to participate in my impeachment process. And we hope the courts will rule that public participation is critical. Number two, there are changes which require to be done in this impeachment process, because I would not want any of my colleagues, the governor, to go through this process the way it is before various changes have been done. And one of the changes...
I'm sorry to interrupt. What sort of support have you received from your colleague governors, the Council of Governors?
Advice and also financial support from individual governors. Mm-hmm. So I'm quite happy with the governors. And we are in it together, and they enjoined themselves to my case in Kiruwea, which we shall carry to the Court of Appeal. In fact, the issues we are taking to the Court of Appeal is to make frequent impeachments impossible by raising the bar of the threshold of the impeachment, so that we don't have impeachment all the time. I've also said that we must now make sure nominated MCAs do not participate in impeachment. In the Senate they were not voting, but at county level they vote, which is very, very wrong indeed. And we would want a situation whereby impeachment threshold is clarified by the courts and eventually accommodated in the registration by the Senate.
Okay, thank you for those remarks, but our panelists here made some observations, similar observations, about your management of your relationships, which is that even if the courts find in your favor, you still have to go back and work with people who have worked against you. Are you going to do anything differently? Do you see that you could have done anything differently? Do you think that your handling of the politics needs some work?
As I said, yeah, we are going to do more politics. We are concentrating on management. And it's true, we need to work closely with the people who matter, especially the MCAs. And I think it's not all lost. It is possible to narrow after we are through with the process.
Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Okay. So our time is up here on Cheche. Our thanks again to the embattled, rather than former governor of Embu, Martin Wambora, for your time this morning and for sharing your concerns and addressing the charges against you. Our thanks also to the insights and opinions of our panelists, Mutegi Njau and David Makali. Thank you for watching Cheche on Citizen TV. My name is Udwa Kamimo. Do enjoy the rest of your week.